Hey everybody, it's FortyWare. Welcome back to Super Mario 64. We took care of Course 10, Snowman's Land, onto Course 11 now, the Water Puzzle Land. Which, we learned, can be flooded with paint. So that's going to be the first foremost thing I do. Actually, no, it's not going to be the first foremost thing I do. I'm going to try to do the first one straight up. You jump into the very bottom, you'll be able to render this place completely dry. Wet, dry world. Or, if you flood it, well, you can flood it by going high, so you can do either, or you can just go in the middle. Shocking Aerolith would be our first goal, and, yep, there's a spider right there, if you care. And, since it takes more of a puzzle roll, it can be pretty interesting to manage. First, of course, there is the crystals. There's also a shit ton of coins here, so this is gonna be one of the easiest to 100. Just make sure you have enough coins in this area right here, because you won't be able to manage that in the other area. Because in Wet Dry World, there are two areas, which is why this is a reasonably large course. Two full-fledged areas. Also, apparently that didn't work. Now, normally, I used to cheese this. Like, I would just flood this SOB and then maybe hit one of the higher crystals, but not that one. And just go from there. I'm not doing that this time. Wow. I didn't think I would do that. 99% of the... Alright, maybe not 99%. That's too much, but... Mario, don't be a dingus now. Say about 85% of the time, I usually get zapped. If you get zapped, I think you can fall pretty easy. So, that would suck. Didn't have to worry about that this time. I'm gonna try to do mostly straight up, I've decided. Top of the town. Well, that's easy enough. You just simply go the other way. And by going the other way, you just simply go as high as you can go. Without fear of any consequences. Also having moving block stops. Now, the biggest thing about the coins here, why I say this is one of the easiest, is because if you've played before, you know there's a lot of enemies that give out pretty copious amounts of coins, like this guy right here you haven't seen before, who just basically is a chucking bomb. He just loves to chuck people and he doesn't necessarily detonate. A chuckster bomb, I guess you could say. There's also a bunch of 10 coin blocks that help, and there is a blue block that contains like 35-40 coins overall. Pretty awesome. Here we go. At any rate, doesn't matter right now. Okay, top of the town complete. Actually, I wanted to flood that right there. Shoot. Secrets in the shallows in the sky. Well, I could do that. But, I'm not. I'm gonna do something else instead. I'm gonna go to the lowest crystal, and I'm gonna do the next, star. Simply because I feel like it. Sometimes the spiders walk, and other times they just, like, glide on the minimal water. So you're not sure what you're gonna get. It just sort of happens. If they're on land, they'll walk, obviously, but if they're in the water, I think it's a 50-50. Case. But anyway, the way I used to get up and the way I think you're intended to get up is to simply do this. But you gotta be careful how you do this, because 99% of the time, this happens to you. And you don't want to get flipped to the floor below, because that would completely cancel out any momentum you had. Ah, perfect timing. You gotta recharge. I don't know how they self-wind up, but they do. Okay. Once you get up here, Now, I don't know how people normally do this. This is a secret, by the way, somehow. You're supposed to take the thing, go down, and walk your way up. But I usually try to get a head start by being an idiot. And, well, I completely effed up. Now, there's, you could probably backflip your way up or do that, backside flip thing. Not the backflip, but whatever the hell it is. I used the wall kick because that's just quicker with the momentum. Instead of cutting your own momentum, sure, you just simply let it ride. Alright, let's flood this sumbitch. There you go. I'll do it. Secrets in the shadows in the sky, and of course the star will be right in the middle. With this, I should be able to access this guy really quickly. This is actually higher than the highest crystal. That's why this is the only way I think you can actually access the Ba-Bomb. And by extension, the final two stars. But I'm going to do the secrets one right now, and I'm going to try to keep it 100 as well. So, there's that. And normally, I'll go ahead and render this world dry once more. Because there's a lot of coins here that you can only access when the water is at its lowest. By which I mean, well, no higher than a puddle. Such as these things right here. And of course the blue blocks. The blue block. And, yeah, it's the only way you can actually beat up any of the spiders that happen to be in the water when you do this trick. Because otherwise the coins will sink. That would not be a good thing. I feel like this is one of those courses where I shouldn't be a fan of it, but I am. I think just because it's very unique. It's pretty innovative. It's... Well, it's got a huge amount of coins, that's for damn sure, so I don't have to really worry about the 100 too much. Yep, that's how I'm going to measure the quality of a course right now. That's how I'm going to measure it. I'm going to measure it simply and strictly by the ability to access coins. If you're wondering, this is the default if you enter in the middle. But there's still way more coins to get. If I don't happen to have enough, I'll just simply go to the other side now that I have the cannon accessed. But if not, well, if I can avoid it, that'd be awesome too. You're gonna be like that, huh? Alright, fine. We'll be like that. That's why man will always triumph over machine. That's another thing that kind of interests me. Oh, I gotta talk to the sign here. The mystery is of wet or dry, and where does the solution lie? The city welcomes visitors with the depth they bring in as they enter. By which they mean, how high do you enter the painting? Not the depth of your character, which would probably be a very important measuring stick for how people are welcomed. That's another thing, that's one thing I wanted to talk about a little bit. My parents were telling me about this. They're telling me about this, the car that basically you don't have to drive or whatever, it drives itself, it obeys all the speed limits, and how it's supposedly like accident-proof. Well, accident-proof, I guess, only in the sense of, hey, if you get in an accident, it's the other person's fault, like, 100% of the time. I don't know what to think of that. It sounds great, but I feel like there always will be a time where a man will always trample a machine, like a machine will... A machine won't know what to do in a certain situation, but you will. Let's use a very quick one as an example. Say you're in a bad part of the town. Someone tries to carjack you. Or someone's coming after you. If the thing will always obey the speed laws and whatnot, If the thing always obeys the speed laws, well, instead of getting away, you're gonna be pretty shit out of luck. So I feel like there's gonna be that's just the first situation that came up in my mind. There's probably more. There's obviously more. Here we go! But I feel like there'll always be situations where, like that, where you have to take over, or there's like an emergency, like someone got hurt, or your wife's pregnant or something, and you need to get to the hospital ASAP. Things of that nature. I feel like that extenuating circumstances are why there needs to be an override to that thing, because I can't just. And maybe I'm a bit of a control freak. Maybe that's the reason I'm very apprehensive about it. But that's just the way I think. I feel like if a machine. Well, I think by the whole logic of imperfections can't create perfections. Imperfect beings can't create perfect beings. I feel like that's one reason, and the other reason is just the whole control freak thing. I'm short. Oh! I got the top. Because I forgot that fence is squared off somehow. For what it's worth, I didn't have to flood it. I could simply just hit the highest crystal, and that would have been enough for me to access the cannon. It's just, that way it was quicker. And now you get to see the second part of town. And there are a few crystals here. There's one up top, and then there's one right at the bottom. There might be two actually at the bottom. There's also a metal cap, which I think has absolutely no importance. I also don't know what this goes to. It doesn't go to those, I know that for a fact. Also, thankfully, those fiery things don't work. Because water. I actually don't remember what that block is for. I actually don't remember. I should did a triple jump there. This is the way as you get around. I'm not sure if this is the way you're supposed to get around. You could also try to time it so that once you hit the crystal, you just simply work your way around. Work your way around very quickly. And try to get to one of the rooftops before the water completely goes away. So I'm not sure what your opinion of that would be. Is it great that freaking thing didn't want to do that? Ah. One. I said. He's not. There we go. There you go. Did it. Like I said, there's a bunch of coins here too. Obviously, you're running short, but as you noticed, I didn't need it. So yeah, I'd be interested in what your opinions would be. Is it a great thing that they're doing this? I think it is, but at the same time, let's just say I don't think it's the right idea to just completely have people not drive ever. Ever again. Even if there are idiots out there. If there isn't a, well, that's not what I wanted to do. Although that was actually kind of interesting. That's four. Five, I think, might be over here. Yep, five's right here. In old school Mario fashion, jump up and knock the thing down. Six. And I think there's two-ish right around. Yep, there's one right there. It's just a bit of going around town and knocking, finding the rooftops. There we go. One more and I should be done here. Once again, I gotta go in town for that. race through downtown! Exclamation point. Okay, that's kind of over. It's not really a quick race. It's just a race. A race with a very handy shortcut. And it's not like you're racing somebody, you're racing time. As if you weren't doing that with the Express Elevator Star earlier. Okay. Last time I barely made it over. Maybe I'll get lucky this time. Let's see. Right here. Let's do more of a line drive. Oh! You gotta be kidding me. Edgy, wait a minute. I'm a moron. I completely forgot about that. Only possible if you do it with the highest of the high, because the highest crystal doesn't go up this high. Alright. Wow, 90 stars already. That means I'm 3/4 of the way through the game. Dang. Yes, I can math pretty good. After all, I am an accountant, and I do work in taxes and audit. So basically, I'm not the type of guy you want to... No, I'm not the guy that's going to get you audited if you piss me off, so don't worry about that. I know a bunch of people out there, you tell them you're, you work in tax or you work in the... work in audit, that they think you're just going to be the asshole who rats them out to the IRS. Or worse yet, you work for the IRS. Which, fun fact, is actually seriously understaffed. No, I'm serious. The, IRS is extremely understaffed. Part of the cause of this is now they've gone more automated, because now more returns are being filed electronically, which you probably don't care about. And part of the other part of the reason, and this I picked up on Last Week Tonight with John Oliver, I don't really watch it. So I know I don't really watch that. I just know of it. Is Republicans who have been in the Congress have been able to cut the spending. Government spending, and one of the government departments that takes the hit is the IRS, which of course nobody likes, so that's the other reason. Anyway, now that little thing aside, scale the mountain. Now they start just using two word descriptions, whether it's tall mountain or wet dry world, or the next one, which is like tiny huge island. Let's start using that. Now, I think I'm going to do that star first, the actual scaling. And I'm going to do it the straight up way because I feel like I owe that. But I also want to talk to Mr. Babam at some point. You know, I won't do that now, but I'll do it later. Also, don't hit that monkey whenever you do, because then the monkey will grab your hat. And then you'll have to... Well, how should I put this? Mario, a good guy, will have to end up being cruel to animals. And you don't want that. Because animal abuse is not cool ever. That is the only thing I will agree upon with PETA, because as you know, I despise PETA. Or if you don't know me, now you know that. I despise them and their ulterior motives. Also, that was pretty unfortunate. But, yeah, we're almost at the top now. It's actually a lot quicker than I remember. Or maybe I just know what the hell I'm doing, so maybe I'm not, you know... Well, playing as conservatively. Also, watch out for that cloud. I don't know what happens if that cloud knocks over your hat. I do know this. It's not very easily attainable afterwards. As in, I've had it happen before, and I've ended up just resetting the game because I don't know where the freaking hat is. Although, I'm good enough to the point where I probably could complete it regardless of whether I have a hat or not. But whatever. Anyway, I think just asked you to make it to the top again. The second way to make it up to the top is to simply take this rock face right here and just climb your way up. There's a bunch of coins here too, so... That's the other reason you would actually take this. But if you weren't interested in that, well, it might interest you to know that. And with that, now we've made it up, and this should bring us right to the mountain side where the waterfall shows up first. I honestly don't know where the hat's supposed to be for the cloud, so if you had that misfortune happen to you, just like that misfortune just happened to me right there, please let me know. I actually would be interested in knowing. I'm also interested in knowing how that monkey cage is just suspended in midair. And now it's time to do our favorite thing. Animal abuse. Sometimes a monkey doesn't do that. Sometimes a monkey just, like, keeps running into a corner for no reason.
Ow, let me go! Okay, oh, yeah, I'm going to get your dick a joke! I'll tell you what, listen, let me go! Give me something really good!
All right, three of our hold on. Well, because we're good guys do these things even if they're completely gullible. We free him. At least the monkey does sort of hold up his end of the bargain. And by sort of, I mean I'm honestly not sure whether this is meant to be a trick or not. A trick that just happens to go in your favor. Now I have to wonder, is the monkey just trying to troll you here and do an unsuccessfully terrible job of it? Or was this... I don't know what to think. I honestly have never figured it out. Is it prank? Is it not a prank? Either way, it's damn effective. Here we go! And with that, that's another star. And you know what? I'm going to stop it here, and I'll finish up Tall Tall Mountain in the next part. See you guys in 40 words. Signing off.